Okay, once again, thank you for the introduction and for the opportunity to showcase our work at the Global FrameNet Tuesdays. Let me elaborate a little more on our department. The Department of Computational Linguistics has created a wide range of language resources, as you mentioned, including dictionaries, lexical-semantic databases like Bulgarian WordNet and Bulgarian FrameNet, corpora like Bulgarian National Corpus and Bulgarian Sense Annotated Corpus, and tools for language processing by Bulgarian Language Processing Pipeline, named entity recognition, and term extraction. We are working on creating an ontology of stative situations as part of our present research. We are developing multilingual language resources for the EUE translation service as well. At the same time, we continue to work on the Bulgarian WordNet, FrameNet, and multilingual image corpus. And now I'm starting with my presentation. Okay, first, I would like to present the structure of the presentation, which is as follows. First, I'll go over a few aspects of Bulgarian grammar with an emphasis on verbs. I will then present the current objectives of the Bulgarian FrameNet project. And in more detail, I will discuss our approach based on quantitative and qualitative criteria, which aims to identify verbs belonging to the general vocabulary. Then I will show our automatic mapping of FrameNet frames to word networks insets, and we'll discuss the Bulgarian FrameNet lexical, morphological, and frame sections. Finally, I will briefly present our future work. Some general facts about Bulgarian. Bulgarian is spoken by less than 9 million, unfortunately, native speakers, mainly in Bulgaria, but also in Europe and North America. The official alphabet is Bulgarian, is Cyrillic, and Bulgarian is the first Slavic language with its own writing system, which dates from the 9th century. Actually, there is a proposal, Cyrillic alphabet to be called Bulgarian alphabet, and that's why I made this mistake. Bulgarian belongs to the family of South Slavic languages and forms part of the Balkan Linguistic Union. As a Slavic language, Bulgarian possesses a rich inflectional and derivational morphology and verb-aspect pairs. However, due to the mutual influence of Balkan languages, Bulgarian has lost noun cases, except the locative, and completely lost the infinitive. In particular, Bulgarian verbs are the most challenging aspect of the Bulgarian grammar. Bulgarian verbs are inflected for person, number, and gender. A verb form includes a participle. The verb have forms for tense, voice, mood, evidentiality, as well as lexical aspect, perfective and imperfective. There are some examples. Zapeya, start singing, is a perfective verb. Zapiavam, sing of, is an imperfective verb. Peya, sing, is imperfective verb with no perfective equivalent. And povyarvam, get to believe, is a perfective verb with no imperfective equivalent. Perfective and imperfective verbs in Bulgarian express different meanings, although the verb aspect pairs are derivationally related. For example, rudyam, give birth, and rajdam, I am giving birth. The different meaning of verb aspect pairs reflects both morphologically and syntactically. Perfective verbs do not have the so-called present tense. They do not form present participles nor negative imperfective forms. Perfective verbs do not form some types of the verbal nouns. The direct objects of perfective verbs cannot remain implicit, and perfective verbs do not form middles, optatives, impersonal passive, and impersonal optatives in Bulgarian. With respect to the development of the Bulgarian FrameNet, our objectives include to select verbs belonging to the common, to select verbs belonging to the common vocabulary, to map FrameNet frames to WordNet synsets, to confirm the validity of FrameNet frames for Bulgarian, and to add Bulgarian language specific data. In FrameNet, as you know better than me, all lexical units evoking a semantic frame have identical or closely comparable semantic descriptions. They denote the same part of a scheme, have the same number of types of frame elements, and the same relations between frame elements. The Bulgarian FrameNet follows the same rules, with the exception that we're currently focusing on verbs. The Bulgarian verbs are selected according to several criteria: frequency, affiliation to the age of acquisition test, the position of Bulgarian structure, the position in the WordNet structure. Relative frequency represents frequency of verbs in the Bulgarian National Corpus, in the whole corpus, and also in the fiction text and in the news. And frequency in verbs in Bulgarian textbooks from first to fourth grade. The frequency is calculated at the level of lemma. However, some noise is left due to the lack of sense disambiguation. The Bulgarian National Corpus consists of over 5 billion words and represents the lexis of contemporary Bulgarian. Verbs with high frequency, over 10 per million words, that are found across different domains were selected. We also cross-checked the identified verbs against the small corpus of school textbook texts. Verbs of high frequency appearing in textbooks in at least two subjects are deemed to belong to the general vocabulary. The age of acquisition test shows the school level at which a word, namely the meaning of a word, must be studied or mastered. The resource includes a list of 31,000 words and compound words, which are not only verbs, compiled by Dell and O'Rourke, Living Word Vocabulary, and supplemented by estimates from other authors. Acquisition rating are a self-esteem given by adults, mostly students, about the age at which they learned a word, which is also further adjusted by other assessment and experiments. Our assumption is that words from general lexis are mastered at early school age. Root distance is the distance of the verbs instead to the root of a local tree, the hierarchical structures in WordNet. The distance is represented by the number of nodes, synces, between the node in which the corresponding verb is located and the representative root, a node with an abstract meaning in WordNet. The assumption is that verbs belonging to the very abstract or to the very specific nodes, which express very abstract or very specific manner of doing something, do not belong to the general vocabulary. Those are the roots and the leaves of the subtrees. Related is the notion for base concepts, which typically satisfy two main criteria: a high frequency and having many relations to other concepts. WordNet synces, lexicalizing base concepts, are therefore also among the candidates for general vocabulary. The presented measures were evaluated by experts in order to select a proper set of general vocabulary of verbs for Bulgarian. The experts used a hierarchy of heuristics. For example, if the following criteria are fulfilled, the verb is part of the age of acquisition test, the distance to the root is one, and the verb is a member of the base concepts, then verb is selected. As a result, we obtained a data set containing 5,074 verbs organized in approximately 3,000 synces. One to the same semantic frame might be evoked by lexical units which are encoded either as synonyms or as hypernyms and hyponyms in the WordNet semantic structure. For example, the verb head is a synonym of the verb detest in a synset expressing the meaning defined as dislike intensely. The synset hate detest has a hypernym dislike with a definition hate or feel a dislike or distaste for, and so on. And all verbs mentioned evoke the semantic frame experiencing focused emotion. The semantic frames of FrameNet have been automatically mapped to the Bulgarian WordNet. The WordNet to FrameNet mapping is based on the three previous lexical mappings provided by within FrameNet. from extended word frame net and from MapNet, and also structural mappings within WordNet. The unification of mappings resulted in 4,306 unique mappings. As a general procedure, the hypernames frame was transferred to the hypernames in the cases where the hypernames are not directly mapped to the FrameNet frame. As a result, over 13,000 synsets were automatically assigned a FrameNet semantic frame. After the automatic mapping, a series of procedures have been carried out for improving the results. For example, searching for an additional match between literals in a given synset and the FrameNet lexical units in the related and sister frames. As a result of these steps, over 9,000 new suggestions for more specific or other possible frames have been made for 5,661 synsets. And for 5,025 frames, manual validation was performed by our experts. So for these frames and synsets, we can with great degree of confidence say that the mapping is correct. Now I'm going to present our work with BullFrame, a web-based system designed for creating, editing, validating, and viewing conceptual frames. The functionality of the system is divided into three main modules: definition of the abstract structure, description of particular frames based on the defined structure, and public access to frames with a read-only restriction. The semantic frame is divided in three sections: lexical, morphological, and frame section. Lexical section includes verb lemma, if the verb is a multi-word expression, its type, part of speech, WordNet interlingual index to which the word belongs, sense number, sense definition, semantic class, stylistic or usage note, and relations with literals from other synsets. We worked further on the definitions to ensure that they accurately capture the morphological characteristic of verbs. For instance, the limited person paradigm as third person, impersonal, and plural personal, as well the lexical aspect. Bulgarian FrameNet contains semantic relations that are inherited from WordNet. These are non-hierarchical relations like synonymy, antonymy, workgroup, associ, and cause, and hierarchical relations like hypernymy, troponymy, and subevent. The relations in WordNet are defined between synsets. Due to the fact that verbs in the Bulgarian WordNet are combined into a single synset, regardless of their lexical aspect, a number of rules to split synsets are put into place while still maintaining WordNet relations. For example, hypernym of an imperfective verb can be only an imperfective verb, or with the relation verb group could be linked both imperfective and perfective verbs, and so on. The morphological section embraces the grammatical information for Bulgarian verbs depending on their subject, their object, and verb aspect. For example, we have distinguished three groups of grammatical subclasses of Bulgarian verbs depending on their object: transitive, intransitive, and neutral. There are some examples to show that why we classify each verb morphologically, because morphological classification actually provides information about the possible diathesis for each lexical unit. For example, if the source verb is the imperfective transitive two-place predicate with a human subject, an agent, and the complement inanimate noun phrase, which is affected by the action of the verb, the middle diathesis is possible. And this is the resulting structure. The derived middle verb is built in Bulgarian with the middle marker se, and its forms are reduced to third person singular or plural. The semantic role of the source subject is reduced while the semantic role of the source object is changed. The derived diathesis represents a stative eventuality type, which determines the only imperfective verbs can participate in the alternation. One more example. The optative diathesis in Bulgarian is derived from personal transitive imperfective verbs with the full paradigm of the category person. Optative verb has the same number of semantic arguments as the source diathesis, and the semantic role of the source subject shifts from agent to experiencer. The subject is derived from the source object. At the morphological level, the optative is characterized by a reduction of the verb paradigm to the third person singular and plural in Bulgarian. We are now going to the frame section. One part of the elements in the frame section are inherited from the Berkeley FrameNet. Another part is constructed in compliance with the FrameNet organization, and yet another one is specific for the organization of the Bulgarian frames. The FrameNet related parts are frame name, frame definition, frame to frame relations, and frame elements with their names, status, core, non-core, and extra thematic, and definition. For example, the frame attack is inherited from FrameNet. However, no frame has yet been created for the verb играя golf to golf. Another example, the frame breaking apart is transferred from FrameNet since there is no lexical unity in FrameNet, translation equivalent to the Bulgarian verb. The syntactic data is currently directly encoded without annotations. Within the information encoded thus far, we plan to conduct experiments to automatically annotate the corpus with the frame elements, their syntactic categories, and their grammatical roles. Each conceptual frame element is associated with a set of nouns that are compatible with the verb predicate. Again, the set could contain a single noun or several nouns linked between each other with lexical relations, synonymy, antonymy, and or hierarchical relations, hypernymy, hyponymy. The association between the frame and its elements can be implicitly introduced in WordNet by means of syntagmatic relations. If more than one noun synset can express the frame element, which is the usual case, the syntagmatic relation links the verb synset with the topmost noun synset of the hierarchy, grouping nouns with the same semantic properties, semantic class. The diversity in the compatibilities drive the necessity for a detailed ontology of semantic classes. And the semantic classes of nouns in WordNet might be subdivided into a set of semantic subclasses. For example, within the semantic class food, we can introduce the subclass of beverage for nouns associated with the verbs like strip, sip, drink, lap, etc. Such representation aims to specify the organization of concepts into an ontological structure which allows inheritance between the semantic classes down the hierarchy and ensures more precise specification of verb noun compatibility. The frame elements experience and content from the frame experience and focused emotion can be linked with the following semantic classes of nouns: person, animal, physical entity, and abstraction. The combinations between classes are the following: experiencer, which is person or individual, and content, which is physical entity or abstraction, and experiencer, which is animal, and content, which is physical entity. Inheritance is important in the way that all noun synsets that are hyponyms of a synset representing a particular semantic class should inherit the properties of this class. This is generally true, and if the inheritance relations of nouns further specified, noun synset hierarchies can serve as sets of words eligible to fill in particular word predicate slots. And as future work, we plan to take full advantage of the semantic features available in Bulgarian FrameNet, of the wide coverage selection of preferences and verb level grammatical information by employing them in semantic role labeling tasks. And at the end, I'd like to thank Bulgarian National Fund of the Ministry of Education and Science for providing us the opportunity to perform this research. And also thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.